Hey guys, so even when I'm not going to buy anything, and that's mostly the case, I'm not going to buy anything, I like to check in on the Apple's App Store and see what's been updated. And most recently, I also like to, I'm more focused on like the game section than the other sections, although these other sections are interesting. I get to see like what brand new apps are out and whatnot, and what the editor choice is and things like that. But interesting thing I noticed with this most recent update, in regards to actually the game section, it's just like how, like, the you know, this phone gaming, mobile gaming, and now tablet gaming is considered part of that as well. Like, how far we progress in that stage, like, is that, like, almost everything that I saw in this update were sequels. And I was just like, whoa, this is crazy. And a lot of them I actually wanted to get. I wanted to spend a lot of money on some of these things. The only problem is I would be willing to spend the money, I just don't have the time right now to actually play them. And I already have a couple apps that I'm spending time on right now. So I just don't have the time, but like I'm just like looking at these, it's like, whoa, Rayman Fiesta Run. Like, I love the previous game, Rayman Jungle Run. I actually paid money for that. And like I was amazed by, like, I was playing on my phone, like, this, it's not an endless runner, but it's a mission-based runner with Rayman, and the way they structured it, like, I love the art style, the graphics, and the premise of it. And then there's a sequel to it, and this looks totally awesome. I was like, dang, that's there. There's the Star Wars Death Star. Wait, no, Tiny Death Star, something like that, which is the kind of like the sequel or the iteration of the Tiny Tower. And I actually did play Tiny Tower quite a bit. I wouldn't say it's a game, and you know, it's not fun. I didn't have any fun with it, but it is, the art style is amazing. The way they structured it is really cool. The pricing model scheme was like, it's a time gate model, so it's frustrating, but it doesn't require you to pay money into it. It's just kind of game to just wait and watch what happens as you tap into things. It's not really a game, but it's kind of interesting that they, you know, spread out to the Star Wars franchise, and you're now building a gigantic Death Tower, which is awesome. So there's that. Infinity Blade 3 came out, you know, like 2 weeks ago or something like that. But like now we have 3 iterations of Infinity Blade, which I think is pretty insane. I played both Infinity Blade and Infinity Blade 2, and I consider them quite amazing games. When I played Infinity Blade and 2 on my phone, like, I was amazed. And then I got my iPad, and just playing those two games on my iPad was something completely awesome altogether. Infinity Blade 3 is here. Oh man, like, what? Let me actually, like, dude, like, all these sequels, like, and really great sequels too. So that just, like, kind of, you know, the impression that I get is like this market has really expanded in such a way, and the constant, it's so constant. Like, I don't even know when these games are popping up. You know, it's pretty crazy how heavy this market has become. And I don't know. A lot of gamers still have this mindset. It's like, oh my gosh, mobile games are like cannibalizing the market, and it's all just freemium stuff. The stuff that like is horrible and like you know, it's a waste of time to play. And in some sense, you know, I totally understand that. Like I said, Tiny Tower or the new iteration, it's not really a game, you know, and it's a very casual experience. And I'm pretty sure it, like, you know, A lot of it is just geared towards the microtransactions, you know, getting you to pay that. But there are, you know, but even so, like, the experience you can have from even some of the free-to-play games without paying money for it. I'm going to make a bunch of videos on my experiences with a couple of free-to-play games. And while there are valid criticisms to be had with these kind of games, I think it's rather remarkable how far we come in regards to tablet games and mobile games. And, you know, just because it's a touchpad control, there are limitations to it. You know, I played a first-person shooter on my tablet, and it was kind of wonky. You know, even with the new intuitive control scheme that they had, like tap here to go here, and tap with two fingers to shoot. You know, pretty interesting way to kind of design your game around the touch controls, and it generally worked, except the pinpoint accuracy I would need when I'm using like a sniper rifle. It's like I couldn't do it, so I had to revert back to this kind of like I see the joystick on the virtual joystick on the touchscreen that I'm using, and I'm kind of scrolling with this finger, you know, while holding the tablet. It's kind of awkward, you know, and the responsiveness is not as fast and effective as a controller with buttons. But it more or less it worked. So there are first-person shooter experiences, which is like the hardcore experience that I've also had on the tablet, and that's not really what, you know, the tablet is for, I feel like, or a phone is for. I had some videos on Real Racing 3, which I thought was quite a remarkable, rather like pretty like actual like racing game that is free to play. And for the most part, you don't have to pay any money into that to get 20 hours or 30 hours of experience on that thing. That is a beast of a game with amazing graphics and amazing like racing experience. You know, and that's not to downplay like actual handheld games. You know, I just think people like there's not enough time. You know, I have a 3DS, and there actually is a game that I have for it that I need to get around playing to it. I just don't have the time, and it kind of is true when you carry around your phone or your tablet everywhere. It's easier for me to just tap into a gaming app for a little while and then close it. Rather than kind of having to charge up my 3DS and take it to places. And I was really big into PSP. My PSP a year ago stopped working, or it works, but it doesn't read discs. And I'm not really the type of person that have a lot of downloaded games for my PSP. I have tons of downloaded games for my PS3, but not really for my PSP. I just have a bunch of PlayStation 1 classics, which I guess I could kind of get around to. But like it generally, when I've been gaming on the go recently, it really has been on my phone or on my tablet. And it's amazing the kind of experiences that, you know, I've been able to have on these things, and even more so on the without having to pay anything. Although that has its limitations, because companies are trying to funnel ways for you to pay that microtransaction. But yeah, I just have to say, it's remarkable where we've come in terms of mobile gaming. And I'm really just wanting to see like where this takes us. You know, like now we have sequels. But like, is this it for the mobile market? Is kind of the innovation just Infinity Blade clones, or Asphalt clones, or there's still a lot of like Farmville clones out there. Like, is that really the extent of this like mobile gaming market? I also forgot, like Sorcery 2 is one of the sequels there. Like, there's so many sequels. It's amazing, and I haven't even played Sorcery 1. I still want to get around to that. And then there's games that have been released as a downloadable title, hardcore downloadable title on consoles. Limbo is now a game you can play on both an Android device and an iPad or an iPhone. Just really insane to me. I've been playing a lot, like a year ago. The fact that I could play Grand Theft Auto Vice City on my iPhone. Like, granted, the controlling issue gets a little bit finicky, but like I could play that. I played Max Payne on my iPhone, you know? I think that's remarkable. I can't imagine an era where that's like, and some of the graphics capacity that can be had on these like phone devices, it's so amazing. Like, it's like it's comparable to maybe even better than some of like the PS Vita games. You know, it's crazy. I can't fathom this world that we come into in terms of phones and tablets and gaming. You know, it's quite amazing.